Ovcharov, probably the slight favourite, but there is a little question mark over his fitness. He openly said after the first game that he hoped his fitness would improve as he progressed through the tournament. He played one singles last night against Brazil. He won. He looked in pretty good form.
You know, I really remember, I've been watching him play for a long time, but in the World Team Championships in Yokohama in 2014 in Japan, right? He comes out with the backhand. The first loss Zhang Jike ever had at a World Championships was against Dmitry Ovcharov in his backhand. The backhand was so good that I gave it its own entity there. Dmitry Ovcharov and his backhand. Like, if there were a band, that would be the name. And now, coming up live, Dmitry Ovcharov and his backhand.
And you'd be happy to be in the backhand.
Yeah, for sure. I'd be the guy on the electronic synth. There we go. Korean fan club here for Jang Woo-jin. Nice to see. Jang Woo-jin has a swag, like sort of a swagger about him, just a style. When he won yesterday, he walked off shaking his head like, that's right, that's right. It was really cool. But acceleration, he stays in the rally with Dima's backhand and then decides now's time. Seohyeowon, Jun Ji-hee, Yang Ha-un across there. The three top women for Korea Republic. What was that?
Just have a look at the service technique. Look how low Ovcharov gets on his knees there. Almost the trademark Ovcharov service.
You know where he got it from?
I can't think of a player who's modeled that technique off. You.
That would be hilarious and highly unlikely, but I'll give you a hint. Where'd you get your last name?
From, okay, from his dad used to serve like that, yeah.
Yeah. You're like, I got my last name from Dima's dad. Whoa, it's Dima's dad. Yeah, all his signature serves. The tomahawk, that low backhand. I mean, if you're at a table tennis party and you want to do name that player without any words, charades, that serve is too easy. Just that's all you have to do is get low, and people in any language will in some way or another say Dima or Ovcharov. Ocha. So trailing by a bit, Dima here. It's a little break off the net, follows it up with the angle. Zhang Woo-jin has very nasty side spin on his forehand too. It hooks and bends, and he's so fast. I wouldn't be surprised to see Dima drive him away from the table and have some long rallies that way. But I think one thing that's taken him from, say, being junior world champion and then sort of a back seat at the professional level to a higher level of play and is going to continue to help him grow as he's only 22 years old in the men's game is that he is staying closer to the table and he is playing more aggressively. Ooh, soft spin. He just rolls it up and guides it with control. Here's another one of the Michael Ovcharov's signature serves. Good read, open racket. A lot of people dump that right into the net. Back edge of the table.
Just heard that. Catch the edge of the table. See on the replay, I'm sure it's just a very fine edge. Yeah, there it goes. Ah.
It's amazing how camera angles change our perspective so much. Who's that?
I don't know, but he's supporting Dima.
That, yeah. No question about that. Maybe it was one of his sponsors. He had an H on the hat. Dima's got the H on the sleeve.
He looked familiar.
Maybe he's one of your former sponsors, too. Probably.
So possibly.
Possibly. Something with a P in it and a Y at the end. So coming out of the second towel break, Jang Woo-jin now up by 5 points here. In terms of preparation, I think one of the best things you can do to play Dima, study his serve. If you can receive all his signature serves, it changes the game quite a bit. And a bit of a break off the net. Jang Woo-jin in solid form here, has 6 game points. But in terms of comebacks, it tends to favor the experienced player. We've seen Dima come back quite a bit. It was against Timo Boll, the China Open last year. He was down 6-10 in game number 7. Came all the way back to take the title. A whole lot of power on that backhand. Not a whole lot of opponent's side of the table. Took his chances there. Five game points left. Korean fans in the crowd, the VIPs. Interesting. Now, as a coach, as Dr. Don, you've got a player who's losing a few points here. It's quite important that he takes game one. How likely would you be to use your timeout if he loses? Never mind. No, for conversation's sake. If he had lost, you would have taken the timeout. I like that.
I think the interesting things with timeouts, there's no right or there's no wrong. You just don't know, do you? And it just seemed to me then, and you summed it up at the end there, you've got the youngster from Korea who's playing the former number one, not that long ago, number one in the world. He has to win this first game. If he lets that first game slip away, then he's really struggling. So I would say that first game is crucial. He's just lost a runner point. The momentum's with Ovcharov. Let's take a break. Let's have a chat. Let me talk to the youngster. Let me just calm him down and let him get in. And that's where my instinct was.
Good call. That replay of the point we just saw showed incredible precision here and risk-taking. Zhang Wujin to the very corner. And the curse of the commentator, the switch right back. Jenny Ovtrob there in a shiny, what appeared to be American football jersey. Jenny Ovtrob, a former player herself, a Swede. Had a chance to hit with her a bit recently in Kazakhstan, actually. I feel like one thing about Zhang Wujin that makes him so deadly, I mentioned it a little bit before, not only his fearlessness, but his side spin in the looping game. The ball just trails. I mean, beating Kenta Matsudaira the way he did, there were so many times I kept saying, wow, Kenta Matsudaira is having trouble contacting the wide forehand. The Canadian national team member sitting next to me, she said, well, yeah, look how much side spin he's putting on it. I'm like, that's a really good point. It just seemed out of character. You know, we're watching on TV. We have a great view. But from where I was sitting, it was tough to get a good seat in the house. I couldn't quite understand why Matsudaira was having so much trouble in the counter loop rally forehand to forehand. Another fun fact for you, Zhang Wujin beat Zhang Jike twice in the same tournament. I believe it was 2015. And there was actually a bit of a situation there, a miscommunication that almost turned into a fight. Zhang Jike was being held back. Yeah, I think there was a discussion about a ball Zhang Jike thought hit the shirt of Zhang Wujin, and Zhang Wujin said no, it didn't. And there was some disagreement on that, and then after the match, I think there was some laughter or something, and it wasn't intended to be ha-ha at you, but it came off that way. And that was I guess it came off that way to the person who mattered most in that conversation. So I think that, which is sad, because Zhang Wujin is a big Zhang Jike fan, and it always has been, so a little bit unfortunate, but that backhand right there is just too fast to even get a racket up for. No shielding that. Don, was that the first you had heard of that drama?
I vaguely remember it, but I couldn't remember the substance of what had actually happened. And it does sound unfortunate, doesn't it? That, yeah, you hear somebody laughing and you assume it's about a particular thing and it might not be quite the same as you thought. And
right.
All of a sudden, it's blown out of proportion.
Yeah, testosterone also, you know, athletes have a lot of testosterone and a lot of competitive energy. So, yeah, whenever I hear anyone laughing, I always assume it's at me. Not with me, at me. Dima here down by one. Zhang Wujin looking to go up by two with his second serve. Oh, what a receive. A tall player like Dima Should be good on the forehand flick over the table, but it's not so easy, especially with the tight serves of Zhang Wujin. That ball clearly had some backspin on it. You could tell from over the table as it slowed way down on its second bounce, keeping it closer to the net. Too often, but we want to see it more and more. He was looking to step around. There was one backhand, that one. I thought for sure he was going to take a forehand with it. And the shot to win it was a backhand from down near the ground.
I think he gave up on trying to get round to play the forehand. He thought, I might as well go at it with my backhand. You're right, the one, he was desperate to play the forehand, but Ovtcharov was very clever there, how he forced him to play backhands all the time. That could be a pivotal moment, a pivotal point in the in this match.
Yeah, I think typically when you have someone that far from the table, you're going to keep it to the backhand unless you think they're turning the corner and you can hit it out of reach to the forehand. But yeah, we've seen a quick point here where maybe it was an effect. I was curious, okay, second towel break. Sometimes after a big point like that, we see a timeout when a second point follows quickly. You start to wonder, maybe my player's confidence is a little bit damaged or dented. Maybe we need to regroup and get them in the right frame of mind here. Let's take them out of the moment for a minute to refresh. Nice change. So earlier on in the game, Zhang Wujin had a similar serve that got a long push back. Watch one more time. And he played it wide to the forehand, this time right into the crossover point. Has Dima with his elbow in his body, racket head straight up.
Interesting choice of return there from Ovtcharov. He sort of almost chopped it back.
Yeah, when you've got as strong of a backhand as Dima has, to play passively there, it's a bit surprising. This is a much better receive here. It's loaded with spin, but Zhang Wujin very well focused and calibrated to counter and add the side spin to it.
So we spoke about the lobbing rally being the pivotal point. I don't think, well, Ovtcharov hasn't won a point since that point. Five consecutive points now for Zhang Wujin.
I wonder how long it'll be the case. The streak continues, 11-5, Zhang Wujin. We'll see, after losing 11-6 and 11-5. First point to break the streak since the point, Don.
With 6 or 7 points consecutive for Korea. Yeah, the back injury is an interesting one, isn't it? We've got 3 or 4 in back injuries at the moment with the top players in the championship division. And I'm not sure, we spoke about the banana and athletes coming across to the forehand side of the table, contorting themselves. But I also think the basic of table tennis is that you play that forehand topspin aggressively, maybe 3,000-4,000 times a day when you're training, and you're vigorously twisting your body when you do it. And then, of course, the key to that is you must do something to compensate so you twist your body the other way as well. And with the best will in the world, you're not going to go 4,000 twists the other way, so you need to find some exercise that will give you the equivalent of 4,000 twists the other way. And I know that there's a lot of work with the medical teams out there working with the various countries to try and prevent. Prevention is far better than cure, of course, but it does seem we've got a few sneaking in. And I wonder whether it literally is the twisting that we continually do when we play this game.
Well said. Man, it's tough when you put it in perspective like that. I mean, the amount of one-sided twisting that you're doing, how tough it would be to actually balance things out with exercise. Now, Zhang Wujin saying sorry in English there. He can get his game into play here. Down 1-4, 0-2. Oh, that is so tough. Zhang Wujin is reading one of the most difficult serves to read, like a book. Just perfectly. So aggressive here. Dima had barely even twiddled his grip back to a forehand grip. So the crowd has not given up on Dima. Dima has definitely not given up on Dima. It's a shorter comeback road than usual in a best of five, but still a long way to go.
Richard Prowser there looking a little bit more concerned.
It's funny, a good guy to talk to, a great guy to talk to, but during a German match, not a good guy to talk to. Let him be. And I think that's the hunger we were talking about, right? Former players, coaches, and whatnot. I mean, he just really, really wants it for Germany. No question about the passion here for Jong Woo-jin again. He's actually one of the most flexible players I've ever seen. Saw a picture of him looking like a contortionist, twisted, stretching. And that's the one that goes into the bottom of the net, the tomahawk. Dima often starts with the racket closed over the ball, so it looks like, it almost makes you think that he's going to hit it with topspin, but by the time he's contacted it, he's breaking the wrist under the ball. Good counter here. I don't know if that was the top of the net or the edge of the racket, but we saw a little apology there. And a good adjustment, too, on the service receive. You could see how open the racket was by the time he contacted that serve, like I was describing, right, Don?
Yeah, no, it was a very good description.
Thanks. Spent a lot of time thinking about it after returning it into the net three times in a row.
You're right. You stand in a position where it looks as though you're going to put the top, but then when you actually hit the ball, a player who's watching carefully will see that, but a player who just assumes and then gets a bit... Not that I'm suggesting you would get a bit, you know, carried away.
I mean, you
away.
Were, and I'll cry about it, but that's okay. Now, it's tough. I've seen a lot of players dump it into the level, even at world class, if they haven't studied him. It's deceptive. You know, it's funny. I have something to liken it to, and there's Jenny Obtrav again, Dima's wife and the mother of Emma, their young daughter. Trying to think of how that riddle goes. It's like, what's white and scary? A ghost. What do you call it if you brag? Boast. If you've got more and you're one of three, you're the first, it's the most. What do you put in toaster? You're like, toast. You're like, no, it's bread. Your mind is already thinking topspin when Dima shows that. Solid setup here to get that third ball attack. This is really important times right now for Germany. Otherwise, they can't afford to lose another match. Timo versus Lee Song-soo could go either way. Franziska versus Jung Young-shik. Haven't looked up their head-to-head, but Jung Young-shik, I think, would be the favorite.
I think you're right.
Ooh, tries to put a little bit more steam on that last one. I don't know. Timeout-wise, I think Kim Tak-soo's holding on. It might just be one more point.
He was thinking about it, wasn't he? He's getting twitchy. You can see he's getting twitchy in the chair.
The 45-degree head angle. We got the timeout here.
Oh, he's gone for it.
He took his time. Yeah, the head lean. You can't see me in the commentator's booth right now, but Don can. I'm doing the 45-degree head. As someone who's deep in thought and rounds, playing for placement and spin. There we go. Wide angle. Sets up the third ball with a subtle serve. Right out of the timeout, this could be a 3-0 victory for Jong Woo-jin.
Didn't quite get the angle correct on the return of serve there, Ovtcharov. Just slightly too open, ball popped up.
And now four game and match points for world rank number 41 to take down world rank number 3 and give Korea a 2-1 lead. Chinese fans in the crowd, even fans of Jong Woo-jin. No question about who that person's rooting for. And he does it, Jong Woo-jin. What are we gonna see? There it is. There's that head nod. Comes back to the bench first for high fives all around. 3-0 over Dmitry Ovcharov. A very solid performance from Jongwoo Jin.